She's like the wind through my tree. She rides the night next to me. She leads me through moonlight, only to burn me with the sun. She's taken my heart, she doesn't know what she's done. Feel her breath in my face, her body close to me. Can't look in her eyes, she's out of my league. Just a fool to believe I have anything she needs. She's like the wind. I look in the mirror and all I see is a young old man with only a dream. Am I just fooling myself that she'll stop the pain? Living without her, I'd go insane.
Is she a warm person or is she kind of a little aloof?
So incredibly warm.
Really?
And has such, she's got the kind of eyes that you couldn't lie to, even if you wanted to.
Yeah.
You know.
That's nice to hear. I've never met her.
And she's so quiet. And she feels strange because she just, you know, ask you, say something. You'll ask her a question. She'll take forever to answer.
Before she ever starts, you mean?
And she's just got these penetrating eyes that just feel like they're going down into your soul, you know? I really, really love her.
Oh, that's nice to hear.
Neatest people I've ever had the opportunity to work with. Very, very serious about her work. And a real caring person.
Well, Patrick, as I was saying, welcome to Dallas.
Thanks, it's good to be here.
And you were telling me that you come down here so often for horse shows,
is it? Yeah, Lisa, my wife and I raise straight Egyptian purebred Arabians in Houston, and we come here for horse shows. As a matter of fact, last year I came here and rode my Western Pleasure Horse in the Southwest Regionals and went top five on it, qualified for the Nationals, and I was shooting Dirty Dancing at the time. So I couldn't ride him, so Lisa took him to the U.S. Nationals and went top 10 in the nation on him. We're doing real well with our horses. Our little filly, our little princess, she went top 10 at the Egyptian event last year and at the Egyptian event again this year. And that's an international show, so it's considered world. We're doing, you know, doing pretty well, but you have to be guided correctly or you can lose your shirt. We have two Arabians, with Tom and Mary Nashville in Pinehurst, Texas, and in partnership with others there, and four fun horses in our mansion, California. That road is on the Astro season. So, horses are my biggest love aside from my wife. We actually just starred in our first film together in Africa. This is another best project here, so called Nomad the Warrior. I just finished three films back to back. They're very dancing Nomad. And I tied the horse on and we're Piper the Warrior and I started again. We're really excited too to get more than Piper. I know. Wilkesboro, north and south, I rode horses all through that year and a half, which I was a year and a half ago, and then Dom. I rode horses, my own horse, a little bit of an idealistic dream. I'd like to be responsible for bringing back Westerns at some point, or partially responsible, or some portion thereof.
My tree.
You'll go up for a Western and they'll say, no, you don't look the part.
She rides the night.
You don't look like you sit a saddle good
next to me.
That's all you look.
It's, you know, in on the same hand, I'd like to be responsible for musicals. So I've got Lisa and I have our production company really happening now, and we're developing three scripts at the moment. One with Gene Kelly, which is really exciting. I mean, to even get to meet the man, much less work with him on a professional level. I'd met him first when he was with Francis Coppola, when they were planning on bringing back musicals. I went in and auditioned for him. I did a Tulsa from Gypsy for him, and one number. And then Zoetrope Foley. And really, the way we got to know him is he came to see a play that Lisa and I and Nicholas Gunn wrote called Without a Word, about our lives as dancers in New York. And I really, really impressed him, and he felt that we were the couple he'd been looking for years, and we started developing this project here. Not sure. And actually, everything's had to be put on the back burner for a bit because he got sick and then went off to Paris to see his daughter. Then Lisa and I have since gone on and started developing another band script with William Blaylock, who was the producer on Grandview, and I did with Jamie Lee Curtis and Tommy. I wanted to keep it quiet for a while, just from like growing up in Texas, in Houston, dancing is not something that's too widely accepted. And I guess really it comes down to that I didn't want to have to fight the stigma dancer turned actor. Now it's, actor with other talents. And so now people are finding out the kind of dancer I am after having established myself as an actor, and it's a point of interest.
Was most of your dancing, though, ballet?
Yeah, ballet and jazz and modern tap. My mother didn't believe that you truly call yourself an artist unless you're well-rounded in every level of the art. I made my living as a singer for a lot of years. Really did me a lot of good, especially dancing with ballet companies, because when you have a choreographer like Twyla Fark or someone come in and set a ballet, many ballet dancers are very stiff when they're asked to work in some free form movement or in a jazz class. They look like ducks out of water a lot of times. So it really, really helped me move up in the dance world fairly quickly, because I can do, everything. I hate the title of Dirty Dancing. Absolutely hate it. Oh, I can't open that. Okay. Move on to my show. It's a way to unplug you. Oh, yeah. I hate the title of Dirty Dancing. The studio does test marketing things, and it tested well, but I'd like to know where they tested it. They definitely didn't test it in Middle America or the Bible Belt. But Dirty Dancing is specific to, from the writer's point of view, that's what they called this type of dancing when it started moving out of partner dancing into more of a freedom of expression in your movement, Dirty Dancing is not what it sounds like. Mom and Dad out there, it's not a terrible movie. It's rated PG-13. It's a great film for kids and the family. It does definitely have some heat to it and some passion, but it's more of an innocent passion of two kids trying to find out who they are in life and where they're going to go, and not allowing themselves somehow to be restricted by society or social standards and find out who they are and make their dreams come true. And the dirty dancing they're talking about is the Hully Gully and the Froog and the Skate and all, you know, all this kind of, I mean, it's not like,
I look in the mirror,
it's not bad.
And all I see.
Was that always the title, though?
It was called Dancing for a while.
With only but, your dreams.
I didn't call it Dancing. That's Bob Fosse's musical.
Am I just fooling myself?
We all really fought to not have it called
Dirty Dancing. Stop the pain.
Because, you know, I mean, I talked to, well, like the people I were involved with our horses, Tom McNair and his family. They're very God-fearing people. And hated the idea of that title, you know, and it seemed to me that most of middle America would react that way, you know.
Can't
and it's not the kind of film that the title indicates that it might be.